Hi. So a question we get quite a lot is, how long should you wait to leave your painting to dry before you varnish it? Or how long to wait between coats? The best way to understand this is to understand how the paint actually dries. So acrylic paint is a bunch of acrylic beads, microscopic beads, which are solid, you'd think of them like billiard balls maybe, floating around in water with the pigment around them. Now, as the water evaporates off the surface, these beads get pushed together with the pigment in between them. And as the beads touch each other, they have what's called a coalescent, a chemical around them called a coalescent. And that chemical, together with the pressure from the air and the temperature, will chemically bond and form basically a strip or a film of plastic, which is what the acrylic is, impregnated with the pigment. Okay, so when the paint is drying, if you can just visualize what we've talked about, it will depend on the temperature and the humidity as to how quickly the water will evaporate away. Not only that, if you think about it on a microscopic level, a skin forms across the top where these plastic beads, where there's less water because it's evaporated away, and these plastic beads are pushed together and they're touching each other. And that's why we find a skin forming across the top. Of course, with the skin formed across the top, there's less places for the water to get out from underneath. So no doubt you've put on, whether it's been on your pallet or dropped some on the floor or on a painting, you've put some acrylic paint on quite thickly, and you've noticed that it's got quite a thick skin on it, but it's still possibly even wet underneath. That's the phenomenon we're seeing. So if you can relate that back to when you're doing your picture, you put your layers of paint on, if you keep putting layers of paint on the top and the coats underneath haven't had a chance for the water to get all the way out, you need to wait till all the water comes out before you can put a top coat of varnish on. What sort of time are we talking? Well, it's really hard to tell, but firstly, acrylics, be it varnish or the paint, really won't tend to dry or won't tend to cure that coalescing. It needs temperature out of the air as well as air pressure. The temperature in the air needs to be above about 10 or 12 degrees Celsius. And really, probably no one's going to want to paint in below 12 degrees Celsius, but really having it above about 15 is where you want to aim for. Now, at the top end, the problem is if you go over about 25 to 30 degrees Celsius, what you'll find is the water is sort of flashing off the top, and so we're forming this skin prematurely, and that's trapping a lot of water inside. And the longer that skin is allowed to form without or still having water trapped inside, then the longer it will take for that water to come out. So what does it matter if there's water stuck in the paint? Well, in most cases, if you're painting a picture that's going to hang on the wall and it's on canvas and it's not being used as a doormat or a tea tray, then there's actually no real problem at all, as long as you don't put a solvent-based varnish over the top. A solvent-based varnish works in a completely different way and will lock everything in. Also locks everything out, all the bad bits, but it locks everything in. And if you've still got a lot of water in there, the water is not going to be able to get out. Reel back a little bit. So are there any other problems? If you put the coats on really, really thick and don't leave enough time to dry, then you have a potential of cracking caused between the difference in drying times between the two coats or two or three coats or whatever you put on. So you just need to be a little bit careful of that, because if they're at different points, they might still shift. For instance, if you put a really thick coat, and I'm talking about literally several millimeters, and then you put and not let it dry maybe an hour or two, it's got a skin on it, and then put some paint over the top of that, but a thinner coat, that thinner coat will actually dry more quickly, so will remain rigid, but the coat underneath it is actually still trying to it will shrink a little bit as the water comes out, and so there'll be movement there, and you can end up with cracking. Now, we do talk about this with water-based varnishes in other videos, but the other thing to note is if you put a water-based varnish on and there's still water in it, you'll notice with the varnish when you first put it on, it's a sort of milky sort of colour. As I say, we go into more detail as to why that is, but it's a difference in refractive light indexes, and so it looks milky with the water and the acrylic, but once the water goes, it's completely clear. Now, you can varnish a painting that you might be suspicious has got a little bit of water in it, not too much, and just with a water-based varnish to finish to keep it safe, that will still slowly let water through. But once again, it's exponentially. It might literally be months before all the water comes out. But certainly, if you're a bit suspect that there's water still within the work, don't put a solvent-based varnish over the top. So if you've got a question, please feel free to email us. We'll try and do a video for you. We'll certainly get back to you with an email. And don't forget to subscribe.